Vice Prisma, very, very thankful to TEDxLeh and associate members, local members, for my inclusion in this event. And today, ladies and gentlemen, I am going to share my experience on the changing face of Ladakhi culture. As you know, that Ladakh is not only known worldwide for its geographical features, but more importantly for its unique culture and traditions, which have been transcended as a legacy from the great Dharma Rajas of this land. The credibility for sustaining a comprehensive and exemplary culture definitely goes to the Dharma Rajas of Ladakh, who were bent on uplifting the unique identity of this land against all odds. In spite of the low population figure, Ladakh is considered one of the richest cultures in the world, so much so that hundreds of people across the world throng this place to catch a glimpse of much acclaimed cultural traditions here. The reason behind its popularity can be attributed to the 10 senses of knowledge, which is broadly categorized into 5 major sciences and 5 minor sciences, which are first Dharik Bar, the science of words and language, the grammar. Sadmarik Bar is about logic. Zorik Bar describes mechanical arts and crafts. Suvarik Bar, the science of healing and medicine, which Dr. Smandasar expressed all the things. Namton Rikpa, Buddhist spiritual knowledge. Nyanga Rikpa, which is poetry. And Manjo Rikpa deals with the synonyms. Debjo Rikpa, science of metrical composition. Zosgar Rikpa is the science that relates drama. And the 10th is the Sis Rikpa, is about astrology. The most important one being the Namton Rikpa, which constitute Buddhist philosophy and even the teachings of Buddha himself in the form of Kargil and Fandi. Ladakhi culture, though, have over the centuries been able to be maintained in complete harmony, but with the passage of time, its indulgence in the so-called development phase has become inevitable. Changes owing to globalization is taking place everywhere. Ladakh is also caught in the web of this metamorphosis. I am not saying changes should not happen at all. Changes and development are necessary, but not at the cost of losing your own identity. Being a famous tourist destination worldwide, Ladakh is flocked by hundreds of tourists every year, and they become a subject of fascination to be followed blindly by the youngsters in the particular. Western influences are increasing alarmingly. That if steps are not taken right away, the results could be very ugly and adverse. Such influences, I feel, are not digestible because Ladakh bears an unparalleled culture owing to its geographical isolation and also because of amalgamation of varied origin of races. These sudden changes and influences is what I term as blind development. For example, in the past, the people of Ladakh are used to travel on horses and mules. Then there is abrupt escalation to air transportation. In between, the other means such as bicycles, motor vehicles are skipped because the people abruptly move ahead, and such sudden changes are totally uncalled for and bound to cause negative effects. Changes in lifestyle of people are unavoidable, but one major area of concern is degradation in Ladakhi language. A language which otherwise is considered a flawless and accomplished language, founded and created by the then great scholar Thonmi Sambota. There has been maximum destruction in the usage of language with the so-called developmental process happening here permanently since the last few years. Ladakhis have not been able to restore their original language, and hence the 10 senses of knowledge are not being followed and practiced properly. Majority of population here Being Buddhist, the great teachings of the Buddha himself in the form of concurrence that you could not be read and well understood, owing to the lack of adequate knowledge of Pothic literature, which I feel is a matter of grave concern. Disrespect to language is a, in a way, means dishonoring the culture of that region, thus endangering its sustaining in the long run. Culture means food, clothing, architecture, language, etc., amongst which language is a subject that has become a mere puppet in the hands of its users with the inclusion of other languages, mostly Hindi and English. This imitation does not much match with our culture, and in the process, we are losing our identity. Madam Helen Norway came to Ladakh to set up Ladakh Ecological Development, in which I also enjoyed the privilege to being one of its founder members. The group thoughtfully started by staging a play, the title of which was Taste Dul, Look Before You Move Ahead Ladakh. Even in those times, I sensed that Ladakh is already heading towards an unguided transformation. The poster of the play was deliberately designed with a Ladakhi man dressed in full traditional costume. The man is seen wearing a traditional cape, kanto, and his head is tilted upwards looking at America's skyscrapers, and while doing so, his cape is nearly falling like this. The poster was metaphoric and represented in the fate of future Ladakh. That is, if we try to follow others blindly, the outcome could be very destructive and negative. In order to make people understand and create awareness about this inaccurate attempt to catch up with development, I felt that need to create a stronger medium. And being a theater person myself, I felt theater is the strongest channel to reach people. And so in the year 1995, I founded my own theater group, Ladakh Theatre Organization, with the aim to restore and sustain the old age, age-old-reach Ladakhi culture and traditions. Following the old tradition of Tibet and Ladakh, I made LTO's official beginning by staging dramatization of Namthar Jataka tales based on compassion, tolerance, kindness, and passion in order to plant these noble virtues in the people's mind. Then I moved on to present the social, cultural, political scenario prevalent in the society. I took up various issues such as corruption, injustice, discrimination on the basis of gender, race, wealth, etc. They were dismantling and disintegrating the society and reflected the same in the form of satirical dramas. The aim was to root out evils that are eating up the foundation of actual development. Development needs to look beyond short-term and immediate results, rather its consequences should benefit people in long run. So often, technological innovations, social changes, and Western influences, which at first sight appear existing, exciting, bring with them permanently harmful side effects. Development is crucial need of the hour, but blind development can be harmful towards our cultural and moral values. On this theme of blind development, I wrote and presented a play called Tasam Mitpe Gyurja. The central character of my play personifies the mind of an individual that is easily influenced by undesirable factors. This thoughtless advancement results in ugly modification in names of persons and places, unpleasant scribbling of messages on rocks, mountains, places, and money walls, old monuments, thereby spoiling the natural beauty of this beautiful terrain. I concluded this play by putting across a question to the audience that whether we should allow such blind changes to occur at the cost of our age-old values and ethics. I mean, theatre actually could make people think and think in the right direction. Theatre is a powerful tool to purify one's mind and cleanse the society of all dark evils and wrongdoings. Despite of its significant contribution towards society, this meaningful art form of theatre is difficult to sustain on account of certain limitations curtailing its growth. There are challenges in the form of other entertainment media like TV, films, internet, and so on. In Ladakh, there is no scope for its progression since there is a lack of even the basic requirements and infrastructure such as auditorium designed for stage place. There is no financial support from the government in spite of repeated requests to the authorities from time to time. Regardless of all constraints, since the last 3-4 years, I have taken up a project for overall benefit of the Ladakhis called Theatre in Education. The concept of theatre in education is very much evolved in most developed countries, but very much alien in Ladakhi society. In order to make people understand the effect of theatre education and to gain support from parents, community and administration, I have been constantly working on this project through workshops, special events, conference, festival, etc. Theatre education in schools could help students in developing ability to communicate their thoughts, feelings and understanding concerning the world around them. Through theatre arts, the students gain knowledge and skills to express their ideas creatively. It also boosts oneself confidence and helps students face challenges, both professional and intellectual. Theatre provides opportunity for personal, social and physical development and also provides opportunity to influence the world. In other words, theatre and education will benefit the future of our children and hence the cultural enlightenment of our community and overall betterment of the society. Keeping in these benefits, theatre and education should be given due consideration and importance because individual striving without any support from parents, community and government bodies would not provide the necessary impetus for its growth. Besides, I face other difficulties in carrying out theatre activities such as death of theatre artists. As the artists are reluctant to participate because we are a non-profitable organization. In other words, we are working for societal development at our own expenses. Let me bring to your notice that the Ministry of Culture, Government of India has set up a different branches of Indian Council for Cultural Relations in Jammu and Kashmir regions. Humble recourse is the government is to set up a similar branch in Ladakh as well, which would help in funding, organizing events for cultural development, cultural exchange programs, and so on. Especially at a place like Ladakh, where there is no dearth of cultural richness to display, establishment of such institution would be of immense help and contribution. Secondly, I would like to extend my recourse to the local authorities, the administration, to design a special scheme concentrating on the development of art, culture, language and theatre, and performing arts in particular, because as I already mentioned, these areas are generally being neglected and therefore need special attention and concern. Sophocles, the great Greek tragedian, wrote, "Wonders are many and none is more wonderful than man." This truly implies that theatre is a dwelling place of wonder, and no wonder how the changing world wonders us. But the art of theatre is a wonder of its own. Thank you.